Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install Next.js version 13 on a Windows operating system. And then I'm also going to show you how you can easily run a simple Hello World project in Next.js on our browser. So do watch the video till the end, and if you face any difficulty in middle, you can always comment in our comment sections. I'm always there to help you. And please do subscribe our channel, that will really help me to make more such videos. So without any delay, let's start our video. Now to install Next.js, you need basically two software. One is Node.js and another is Visual Studio Code. So let's first go to our browser and just simply search over here Node.js download, and you need to click on this download Node.js, and here you need to download the long-term version, that is LTS. Okay, so if you click on this Windows installer, it will going to start downloading the latest version of Node.js. So once it gets downloaded, just simply click on the installer, and it's going to show you the Node.js installation wizard. So it is just simply click on next over here, and this is our license agreement. Just simply accept this license agreement and click on next, and this is where our Node.js is going to be installed. Click on next. All these packages it's going to be installed. Fine, just simply click on next. And it is asking whether you'd like to install Chocolaty. You can skip for now, just simply click on next, and it ready to be installed. Just simply click on install, and it's going to ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes, and it's going to start installing our Node.js. So by the time it get installed, I'll also going to download Visual Studio Code. So just simply type Visual Studio Code download in a new tab, and it's going to show you this code.visualstudio.com as our first search result. So here you can see we have downloaded Visual Studio Code. Just simply click on that, and it's going to redirect to the official site of Microsoft Visual Studio Code. So here, if you just simply scroll down, you can see that we have its Microsoft Visual Studio Code available to download for Windows, Linux and Mac. So in here, you need to click on this Windows version, and it's going to, you know, start downloading our Visual Studio Code. So let's go back to our Node.js installation. So here you can see that our Node.js has been successfully installed. So you can just simply click on finish. So our Node.js is installed and our Visual Studio Code is also downloaded. So let's click on the Visual Studio Code installer, and it's going to show you this Microsoft Visual Studio Code license agreement. Let's first minimize our browser, and in here you need to read this license agreement and click on I accept the agreement and click on next. So this is where our Microsoft Visual Studio Code is going to be installed. You need to have 354.7 MB of free space on our, you know, C drive. So everything is fine, click on next. Visual Studio Code, they're going to create this folder, click on next. So here you need to check this, you know, create a desktop icon, and I am also going to select these two options. This will going to help to open any project by just simply directly right clicking on that project. So it's going to show you on Windows Explorer file context menu and Windows Explorer directory context menu, right? And other things are fine. Basically you need to check everything, click on next and install. So it will going to start installing our Microsoft Visual Studio Code. So let's wait for a couple of minutes. So you can see that our Microsoft Visual Studio Code is also installed and our desktop shortcut is created. So just simply click on finish. So now that our Node.js and Visual Studio Code are rightly installed, let's open our command prompt. Just simply type npx create dash next dash app, and then let's give your project name, my demo app. Just simply hit enter, and you can see it rightly started installing our Next.js app. So you know, for React you need to type create React app, and for Next you need to just type next, that's all. And here you need to give your project name, and here it is asking whether you'd like to create the following package. So why, hit enter. So it has rightly started fetching all the files from internet. So it's important to have an active internet connection right throughout this, you know, installation. And here it is asking whether you like to use the TypeScript for this project. You can use the spacebar to navigate to yes and no. I'll just simply give it yes. Yes linked also yes. src I'll keep it yes. And experimental app directory also yes. And import alias I'll just simply going to hit enter. And you can see it has rightly started creating a new Next.js app. So let's wait for a couple of minutes to create our first Next.js app. So we'll come back, and now you can clearly see that our Next.js app is rightly installed. So you can just simply go inside that our project. So cd type my demo app, just simply hit enter, and you can see I am currently in my demo app directory. So I'll just simply open this in our Visual Studio Code. So I'll just simply type code dot and hit enter, and it's going to open our project in our Microsoft Visual Studio Code. So you can see it has rightly opened. So you can just simply click on I trust the authors and all. So this is our, you know, project structure. So if you go to src, and you can see that we have this page.tsx. So if you need to click on this npm script, if you don't get this option, you can click on this triple arrow and you can enable this npm scripts. Once you enable that, you'll be able to see all these options. So from here you can click on this dev. So just simply click on that, and it's going to start building our project and going to run our project, you know, very soon. Here you can just simply click on allow access, and you can see that our project has been compiled successfully. So if you scroll up, you'll be able to see this link. So you need to just simply click on control and just simply click on follow link, and it's going to redirect to the browser in localhost 3000 port number. And you can see we have this create a next app, our project, and we have Next.js 13 installed. So if you want to, you know, modify anything, so here this is our page.tsx is our file. So here in main, I am going to, you know, remove all this, and I'm going to just simply keep just a p tag, and in that tag I'm going to just print hello world. And when I, you know, going to save this, and automatically it's going to again build and rerun, and here you can see the output hello world rightly shown. Right, so in this way you can easily install the latest version of Next.js 13 on a Windows operating system. If you face any difficulty, you can always comment in our comment sections. And if you need more videos on Next.js, please do comment. I am always ready to make more such videos. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.